George W. Bush announced the commencement of the war against Iraq. The purpose of the war, according to President Bush, was to disarm Iraq from alleged weapons of mass destruction. Senator Robert C. Byrd says, "This is not a war of choice. This is not a war of necessity, but a war of choice." Senator Byrd gives his speech to the members of the Senate on the same day as he started the war. And what truly makes Byrd's speech, "The Arrogance of Power," great is his use of rhetorical questions, contrasting ideas, and the Aristotelian appeal of pathos. To begin, Senator Byrd says, "I believe in this great and beautiful country. I've studied its roots. I've gloried in the wisdom of its magnificent constitution and its inimitable history. I have marveled at the wisdom of its founders and its framers. Generation after generation of Americans have understood the lofty ideals that underlie our great republic. I've been inspired by their story of their sacrifice and their strength." But then he goes on to say, "But today I weep for my country. I've watched the events of recent with a heavy, heavy heart. No more is the image of America one of a strong yet benevolent peacekeeper. The image of America, Madam President, has changed. Around the globe, our friends mistrust us, our word is disputed, our intentions are questioned." The contrasting points of both statements show his love for the country as well as his disappointment and frustrations. He wants everyone to understand that his war is both a war, valid, and they come from a place of loyalty and love for his country, not anything sinister. Senator Byrd uses a multitude of rhetorical questions in his speech. For example, he states, "What is happening to this country? My country. Your country. Our country. When do we become a nation that ignores and berates our friends and calls them irrelevant? When did we decide to risk undermining international order by adopting a radical and doctrinary approach to using our awesome military might? How can we abandon diplomatic efforts when the turmoil in the world cries out for diplomacy? Why can this president not seem to see that America's true power lies not in its will to intimidate, but in its ability to inspire?" Byrd wants the members of the Senate to question the actions that have been taking place in reference to the war in Iraq. He wants to equip the Senate with these questions to inspire thoughts and ideas within the members. Furthermore, Byrd uses the Aristotelian device pathos to appeal to his audience's emotions. Robert C. Byrd isn't presenting any hard evidence. He isn't giving details upon details to prove his point. But what he is doing is playing to people's emotions. Byrd understands that he can't convince anyone by providing illusory facts, but instead he uses words and thoughts to provoke empathy and feelings. For instance, Senator Byrd says, "War appears inevitable, but I will continue to hope that the cloud will lift. Perhaps the dam will still turn tail or warn. Perhaps reason will somehow still prevail. I, along with millions, scores of millions of Americans, will pray. Pray for the safety of our troops. Pray for the innocent civilians, women, children, old and young, crippled, deformed, babies, and sick, in Iraq, and for the security of our home." This statement enables the Senate and the people of America to form a connection to his words through their own feelings and experiences that they have had or still have. Throughout his speech, Byrd uses pathos, disparity, and rhetorical questions to drive his opponent. Byrd's speech was instrumental in creating a movement against the previous war, a war in which the main cause, the alleged weapons of mass destruction, was never even found or confirmed. In January of 2004, David Kaye, the former top U.S. weapons inspector, told Congress, "We were almost all wrong." Byrd's speech truly showed the arrogance of power.